Remake of Pinocchio's coming out. So, the original is a classic, hands down. And Robert Zemeckis has quite the task in bringing it to live action. This is, for me, a more perfect opportunity to talk about the animated film that very few people seem to know about. The 1978 Ventures of Pinocchio. So, let's begin. The film is about a woodcarver named Geppetto who decides to carve a plank of wood. Only this plank of wood turns out to be sentient. And he ends up carving a puppet out of it who he calls Pinocchio, who wants to be a real boy. He goes through many misadventures on his journey to becoming a real boy. So what do I think? Well, I'll tell you. Well, I like this movie. It's a much more faithful adaptation of the original book than the Disney version is. Now let us talk about the character of Pinocchio. Unlike the book, in where Pinocchio was kind of a brat, here he's more mischievous. He's very likable as well, and he does learn from every adventure he goes on. And he really does care about his loved ones. He's voiced by Roberta Paladini. And yeah, Pinocchio is played by a woman. Try to wrap your brain around that. To give you a good example of how Pinocchio cares about Geppetto so much, there's a scene in where Geppetto goes out to buy Pinocchio a spelling book in the snow. And when he comes back, he has no jacket. And we see him holding a spelling book. When Pinocchio finds out that he sold his jacket for just to buy him a spelling book, makes Pinocchio feel very sorry for him, knowing that he sacrificed his own jacket for him. And just like in most versions, this Geppetto is a kind old man, voiced by Dill McKinnon, who also voiced Gumby, as well as voiced several characters on the Archies, as well as voicing Buzzy Buzzard, and did work on Lady and the Tramp, Sleeping Beauty, 101 Dalmatians, Mary Poppins, and Bedknobs and Broomsticks. Next up is the Talking Cricket, who both here and in the book is also called the Talking Cricket. And yes, he has no name. And before you ask, yes, This is the same cricket that Jiminy Cricket was based on. And just like in the book, Pinocchio throws a hammer at him. Hot damn! But he also comes back as a ghost. The ghost of the talking cricket, who often gives advice to Pinocchio. Doesn't explain how later in the film we see him alive again. And then there's the Fire Eater, our first antagonist, if you will. He is very strange in that he sneezes whenever he's sad instead of crying whenever he's sad. He's voiced by Bob Hilt, who is also the voice of both the Lorax and the Onceler in the 1970s Lorax. He was also the voice of Avatar in Ralph Bakshi's Wizards.
I'm glad you changed your last name, you son of a bitch.
Next up are our crooked pair themselves, the fox and the cat, who are sly and manipulative, thieving assholes. Not only do they try to steal and kill Pinocchio, they also try to lie to him by saying that money can be grown like corn by just planting it, and they pretty much rob him, and they get their comeuppance by pretty much ending up being poor and crippled. And when they ask Pinocchio for help, Pinocchio pretty much tells them to do one. The fox is voiced by Les Lai, who is also in You Can't Do That on Television. And the cat is voiced by John Stephenson, who is also in Charlotte's Web, as well as voicing Thundercracker. To give you a good idea of how dark this movie is, there is a scene in where the fox and the cat are dressed in black hoods and are holding knives and are threatening to kill Pinocchio. They even hang him from a tree with a rope around his neck. Approved for all ages. Hot damn! That's not only dark, it's brutal. I mean, look at him. He's swinging back and forth. But thankfully, the fairy with the dark blue hair, who lived in the house, decided to save him. She tries to give Pinocchio some medicine to help him feel better. But Pinocchio, being a brat, refuses to take the medicine. She tells him that if he doesn't take the medicine, he'll die. But Pinocchio basically says he would rather die than take the medicine. Then, four black rabbits come marching in, carrying a coffin. Approved for all ages. Sweet Honey Nut Cheerios is this dark. Pinocchio tells his horrible adventures about what happens. He makes it even more horrible than they were by lying about them, which makes his nose grow. But the fairy with the dark blue hair, being the good being that she is, to send some birds in to come eat off his long nose. I really like the fairy with the dark blue hair and her relationship with Pinocchio. It's very akin to a mother and son. In fact, Pinocchio ends up calling her Mama. She's voiced by Jinji Taylor, who was also the voice of the Squirrel Girl in Sword in the Stone and Polynesia in the 1967 Dr. Doolittle and Black Widow and Jane from Space Ghost. And the design of the Blue Fairy was based on the Italian portrayal of the Blessed Virgin Mary. There's a chase scene between Pinocchio and a bulldog named Alidoro. They both land in the ocean, and Alidoro, the bulldog, nearly drowns. And Pinocchio thankfully saves him. And for some reason, Alidoro looks kind of like Spike from Tom and Jerry. And then we get our introduction to the green fisherman. Very, and I do mean very few adaptations use this character. Although, why is he blue like Papa Smurf and not actually green like his book counterpart is beyond me. But he tries to cook and eat Pinocchio. He's voiced by Arturo Lominici, who is also in Perseus Against the Monsters, Black Sunday, Hercules, 1958, and he was also Prince Osman, a.k.a. the villain in the 1961 Thief of Baghdad. And then there's Candlewick, who in this film is called Uchignolo. He is not as much of an asshole as his Disney counterpart, Lampwick, but he is mischievous, to say the least. He goes to a place called Toyland, and the donkeys with all the shoes should give you a good indication of what's to go down. And Toyland is basically an amusement park, and where the kids can do anything they want. And then we get our donkey transformation. While it isn't as terrifying as it is in the Disney version, something does come close to being as terrifying. The fact that Pinocchio turns into an actual full-fledged donkey like he did in the book, and the coachman coming in and giving this face. No, I'm serious. For a brief second, we see the coachman giving a face. Just look at it. It's not as scary as this face, but it comes pretty damn close. Candlewick, or Uchignolo as the film calls him, is played by Tony Pulp, who is also in Akira. But I find it very ironic that he's in a Pinocchio film when later on he would go on to voice Geppetto in not only The House of Mouse, but in Kingdom Hearts. The film was directed by Giuliano Cinci, who is also an animator on Titanic, The Legend Goes On. The film is narrated by Victor Jury. He's also Oberon in the 1935 Midsummer Night's Dream, and Jonas Wilkinson in Gone with the Wind. The film was an Italian and American co-production and was distributed by GG Communications, who distributed Lucio Fulci and Mario Bava, well, Giallo films, including Hatchet for a Honeymoon and One on Top of the Other, as well as Once Upon a Time and the 1975 Little Mermaid anime and the live-action Pippi Longstocking movies. Well, if there's one thing I could say about this version of Pinocchio, well, this is 1,000 times better than Pinocchio, A True Story.
Father, when can I leave to be on my own? I've got the whole world to see.
Oh, good Lord. Well, until the next review, I'm Henry R. Mockingbird, your host with the mustache, signing off. I give this film 5 stars. Write, like, and subscribe to the channel and ring bell for future uploads. If you like to make a movie request on this channel, do so in the comment section below. And feel free to check out my other shows, Modern Classics, TV Treasures, and Geek Reviews. And check out my editorials. Check me out on Vimeo.